I'd like to talk about a numerical study on movement of tsunami boulder and typhoon boulder by SPH method from Takashi Yamamoto, Kansai University. In coastal engineering, the large deformation problems such as wave breaking, movement of wave absorbing blocks, and sliding of a caisson breakwater is treated. Recently, a lot of research using numerical simulation are being conducted by reason of improving process speed of high-performance computers. Grid method and particle method are typical calculation methods. Particle method simulation is conducted by tracking the particle movement without using computational grid. So it is known that the particle method has more applicable to large deformation problems than the grid method. Some boulders are reported after the tsunami and super typhoon. These boulders are named tsunami boulder and typhoon boulder. Tsunami boulder is expected to lead risk assessment of huge tsunami, so tsunami boulder research has been attracting attention in recent years. The boulder displacement when tsunami act is longer than when high wave act. However, the movement characteristics has many unclear points because of the limited number of observation cases. Kiso et al. Conducted the hydraulic model experiment using boulder models and evaluated the characteristics of boulder movement. This study aims to simulating the boulder movement using SPH method and considering the difference of boulder movement characteristics between different wave types, tsunami and high wave. This research uses Dual S-Physics version 4.2. Dual S-Physics is an open source code based on weakly compressible smooth particle hydrodynamics model. The governing equation of WC-SPH method is consist of continuity equation, momentum equation, and equation of state. In the formula, phi is the artificial viscosity term and W is the kernel function that decides the range of influence of particles. This research uses Wendland kernel function. Red table shows the other calculation conditions. This research uses distinct element method in order to simulate the interaction between solid objects. Next, I explain about the numerical waveform. The experiment is conducted at hybrid tsunami open frame in Ujigawa Labo, Kyoto University, named HiTOF. HiTOF can generate arbitrary tsunami waveforms and irregular storm waves. Boulder model is placed at the edge of the flat slope. When generating wave for long time series, the water level is disturbed by the influence of the wave reflection by piston. In order to reduce this effect, this study uses active wave absorption system. Also, in order to reduce the effect by the wave reflection at the right edge of the waveform, damping zone is set in the right side of the waveform. This area usually consists of porous materials in experiment facilities. Next, I explain about the wave condition. Tsunami simulates as a solitary wave, and typhoon high waves simulate as irregular waves. Left table shows the solitary wave condition, and the right table shows the irregular wave condition. The initial water level is 0.84 meters, which is the condition that the horizontal floor is submerged. Also, I conducted the simulation the case when changing the initial piston position to decrease the computational cost. I would explain about the result from here. This figure is a wave fluctuation time series when solitary wave generated. Left figure shows the wave elevation on the offshore wave gauge, and the right figure shows the wave elevation on the boulder installed position. Yellow line shows the experiment data, and red, green, and blue line show the simulation data when changing particle diameter. From these figures, physical and numerical data are almost the same. In the right figure, the peak value is underestimated by numerical simulation when changing the particle diameter. The peak value is not changed. Also, Altomare et al. Recommended that the particle size is less than 1/10 of the wave height. So in this study, I will analyze the movement of boulders with a particle size of 5 mm. Next, I explain about the wave elevation when generating irregular waves. Left figure shows the result of using the significant wave height and significant wave period from zero up cross method. And right figure shows the result of using the target significant wave height and significant wave period in the experiment. Above figure are the wave elevation at offshore wave gauge, and below figure are the wave elevation at the boulder installed position. From left figure, the wave elevation at offshore wave gauge almost the same as experiment, and the wave elevation at the boulder position is underestimated. From right figure, the wave elevation at offshore wave gauge does not match to experiment data, however, the peak wave height at the boulder position is almost the same as experiment. In the experiment, the time series of water level fluctuation could not be reproduced because of wave height is smaller than the target wave height due to the incorrect setting of the wave generator in experiment. In the experiment, the boulder is moved when the peak wave height is over 10 cm at boulder installed position, and this study focuses on the boulder movement. So I would simulate the boulder movement using target significant wave height, significant wave period. Next, I simulate the boulder movement. I choose two boulders, 10C and 17C, from the boulder used in experiment. Maximum diameter of these boulders is 10 cm and 17 cm respectively. Above table shows the boulder size and under table shows the DEM parameter. This movie shows the simulation result when solitary wave act on boulder. The boulder number is 70C. And this movie shows the simulation result when irregular wave act on boulder. It is confirmed that the boulder is moving when large wave act. I explain about the boulder movement. The above figure shows the boulder movement, and the middle figure shows the boulder moving velocity when solitary wave act. Yellow and green line show the experiment data, and red and blue line show the simulation data. Numerical simulation results of the movement and moving velocity when solitary wave act on boulder 17C is the same as physical result. Also, the displacement of boulder 10C is almost the same as experiment. However, the moving velocity is underestimated. From simulation results, boulder 10C keeps contact with the bottom while moving, so the moving velocity is underestimated. Below figure shows the boulder movement when irregular wave act. Blue and red line is simulation results. Since wave elevation time series is not reproduced, I compare the results with final displacement in the experiment. The final displacement is plotted in yellow in this figure. From this figure, the displacement of simulation is almost the same as experiment. From this result, it is possible for simulating the boulder movement using SPH method. Finally, I explain about the wave direction and rotational moment. The snapshot shows the flow velocity vector just before the boulder starts moving, and the graph shows the rotational moment calculated by the fluid pressure in front of the boulder. The result of solitary wave is shown in the above figure, and the result of irregular wave is shown in the below figure. From the snapshot, when solitary wave acts on boulder, the wave acts upward. And when irregular wave acts on boulder, wave acts horizontally after wave breaking. It was observed that the wave action direction were different. Also, from the graph, when solitary wave act, the rotational moment act continuously. However, when irregular wave act, the rotational moment act instantaneously. And when irregular wave act, the boulder may not move if large moment act. From these results, the difference of wave direction and how the moment act are important factor for boulder movement. This slide shows the main results. This study conducted the numerical simulation of tsunami boulder and typhoon boulder by SPH method. It is suggested that the difference of wave action direction and overturning moment affects the boulder movement characteristics. In this study, the reproducibility of water level fluctuation was low, so we would like to improve the accuracy by using the new version of the coupling model, such as swash model and open boundary conditions. Thank you for listening.